So in this video, we are going to see how you can embed a PHP statement inside a HTML. So this is a example for that. So already you know the HTML tag, so opening and closing. Then within head and title, you can give the what program it is. And then inside the body, you open the PHP tag. So inside body, mostly you'll be giving the PHP coding. So PHP, then here there are two statements. One is echo and print statement. Here echo, hello world. And then, so within bracket, as I said, within bracket also you can give, without bracket also you can give, both will get executed. So here, hello world. Then here we have given br. So this br is, if you give slash in, like C++, which will generate a new line character, that will not work out here because it is a browser. Whatever you execute, you are going to see it in a browser. Browser will not understand slash in. So what you have to do is, instead, HTML, in HTML we have the break statement. Okay, slash this br. So you can give this br in order. So when you execute the statement, first it will print hello world, and then the next line, this will be printed. I am written with PHP. So this will be the again break, and cursor will stand to the next statement. So that is the idea here. Now we'll see a small program how to execute a PHP. So already I've written this program. It's a small program without any HTML code. So without any HTML also it will execute. Then we'll see how to execute it. Now already I have typed this program. Here what this means is, first we are assigning two variables. As I already told you, a variable name starts with dollar symbol. I'll explain the rules and regulations of the variable in the next video. As now I'm just going to explain echo and print statement, how you can embed the PHP in a HTML. So that is what in this we are going to see. So for that we should we have declared two variables, f name, first name and last name, which has some value. So echo, then my name is, see how it has written within quotes. So whatever you have written within quotes, it will be displayed as such. Then dot, dot is a concordation symbol. Okay, even comma is also a concordation. That is comma, you can use comma to separate the variables. So dollar f name and dollar name. Now when you execute this, this will print the value, my name is Abdul Kalam. Now we'll see how it gets executed. As you have seen, you have to save this. Already it is saved, but where you will save is, already I had told you, within XAMPP folder, and you have to go inside the XAMPP folder. There you will be finding htdocs. Okay, in htdocs, you create a folder of your own, and then within that you save. That will be always better. Then when you execute, you will be executing it as localhost, because always localhost means it will address the XAMPP and htdocs folder together. So it will always see your PHP program in htdocs, because now what we are going to do is, we are going to execute this as a server script. So htdocs indicate the server side. So it assumes that whatever you have written, it will be stored there. So from that only it will get executed. So now I'm going to execute this program. Already I have saved it in the XAMPP folder. Now we'll see how to execute this. We'll say localhost double slash PHP, the single slash is enough, PHP pure JS, because that is the name I have given that. So now this file name is echo_print. print.php. See here, it has come. So I have given, I have not entered the full path. I have just given localhost, and then the folder which I have created, within that the program along with the extension. Here it is coming without any space. Now, if I need space there, so what we have to do? We have to give a space like this. So this is also a string. So after first name, the space will be printed, and then this will be thing. Now I'm just refreshing. See here, you can see the space. So like this, you have to execute. This is Ubuntu system, so I'm storing it in OPT underscore OPT slash lab. If you people are using the Ubuntu, then you can go to a computer, and here I have this OPT, and then inside the LAMP, htdocs. That also I will store it in the htdocs where PHP PRJS. Inside this only, whatever program I am creating, I am storing it. So likewise, in as you people are working in Windows, you can directly find your in C colon, in C or in whichever drive you have installed XAMPP. There you have to go. You will be finding XAMPP folder. Within XAMPP folder, you will be finding this htdocs directly. And within htdocs, you create a folder, and within that, you save your programs.